Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to more Until Dawn. I'm your host, TWK of TWK Reviews, so let's get on with the story. Let's actually try to get a mosey on things. Alright, where are we going? Oh yes, the backpack. It's, you can tell it's important because it has a little flashing light on it.
Not in the bag, are you?
Well, I certainly hope not. I mean, we don't really need that type of contortionists around here. Things are already creepy enough as is. What shall we do? Shall we close the bag or Snoopy? Are we gonna be a closer or a snooper? Which one will I choose?
Maybe I shouldn't.
Yeah, we're not a sneeper, snooper, snooper, whatever. That ain't us. That is not our lives. We are better than that.
You made it.
Chris has a crush on Ashley. Alrighty then.
Oh.
Ooh, butterfly effect update. Yes.
Kinda amazing.
Amazing, you say?
I'm not gonna tell you. You gotta see for yourself. Come on.
Alright, I guess we're just going to follow you then.
Right around here. Gonna blow your mind.
This, well-built nerd, I guess one could say. Don't mind me just walking around very awkwardly, because that's how I do.
Ta-da! Pretty rad, right?
Yeah!
Come on, look at these beauties!
Beauties is...
Yes, a shooting range, that is definitely what I would call and classify as rad.
What the hell is a shooting range doing at the base of a ski lodge?
Well, you know, rich people, you know.
Yeah.
They do wacky things like that. And yes, now we're going to control Christopher here. Alright, let's try to aim correctly. Alright, Oh, he wanted to aim over here, alright. Boom! Let's get aim now over here. Yeah, boy! Hitting all of the things.
Wow, nice shooting, Tex.
Alright, I'm bad.
That fucking dance. Jesus Christ, I forgot about it.
I don't think so, girl.
The epitome of cringe.
Well, anybody and their brother could shoot a bottle that big, that close.
Oh, a squibbity squirrel. What, 20% of people actually shot the squirrel? Those bastards.
Nice shot.
Your ass just got sacked.
Boo.
Hey, sharpshooter, our ride's coming.
Wait, I'm just getting the hang of this.
Come on, Chris, the cable car.
Ooh, a burb. All right, and we're off. Get it. Ooh, camera chain. Camera angle. Ooh, camera angle change once more. Oh, what is this? We have ourselves a clue. Yes, there are 30 clues to find throughout this adventure. We'll be finding some of them. I've never been much of a completionist personally, so yeah, don't expect us to go and find all of them.
Nice. I think we'll get a.
However, you know, they're helpful in trying to uncover the mystery. This one. Let's see, wanted, Victor Milgram. Let's see, 6'2". Let's see, Blackwood Pines. Last seen in 98. Oh, lovely, that is a long time ago, even going by this game's standards. Lovely, lovely, lovely.
Someone thought so.
Oh, come on, this place is abandoned most of the year. Nobody comes up here.
Let us continue on our grand adventure.
Locked.
Yeah. Josh wanted us to keep it locked to keep people out.
He said that? What people?
I don't know. He said they found people sleeping in the station one time.
Oh, that is... Yeah, it took the words right out of my mouth, Sammy. Thankfully, Chris boy here had a key.
After you.
Aw, oh, real gentleman.
Cable car's still not here, so let's mosey about.
What a crazy place to set up house. I mean, no matter how rich you are.
They're not so rich. Family bought a mountain.
Can't do anything with the lockers. Ooh, security cameras. There's no way this could possibly be creepy. Not at all. Look, that's just, just being able to view the hot tubs inside the house. That is just the loveliest of things.
How long is this going to take?
It's a big mountain.
Yeah. It's so beautiful today, but at night just feels menacing, like sleeping
giant. You going
to publish? Oh, here comes the cable car. Hooray!
Stay here and catch some Z's, but okay.
And we are off to adventure.
Here we go.
Right. Adventure begins.
Oh.
Indeed, Christopher.
What?
You know, get everyone together on the anniversary. I mean, Josh seemed really pumped about us all doing something, didn't he?
Yeah, no, he definitely did. I haven't seen him so excited about something in forever.
Good.
Man, the scenery here is just gorgeous. They did not have to put this much work into it, but I'm glad they did.
It was a good idea.
I hope everyone else feels the same way.
We're all here, aren't we?
Thanks, bro. Good talk.
You know what? Let's just stop talking about what happened and enjoy the trip.
You know what, you're right.
That would be for the best.
No.
Okay. Third grade. Josh sat in the back of the room, I sat in the front. We didn't even know each other existed. But the kid sitting next to Josh started strap snapping the training bra on the girl in front of him. So the teacher made him move to the front, where I was sitting.
Okay, so?
So I got moved to the back.
And
next to Josh. That's how we met.
Interesting.
Friends. To this day.
A match made in heaven.
If it weren't for the fact that Jeannie Simmons hit puberty like 3 years early and on that day decided to wear a low-cut shirt that showed off her training bra, I mean, who knows? You could be riding in this cable car alone. Right now. Or talking to some other person entirely. Boom. Butterfly effect.
Yeah, I think we all have those kind of situations where we think about where serendipitous things happen, where we end up in sort of situations that wouldn't have otherwise if certain things haven't lined up perfectly. Like, if me and an old friend from school had not been in the same college class, we would not be friends right now. We would like just not even know each other. It's so weird how these things kind of happen. And there's just another character, Jess, Mike's new girlfriend, and oh boy, is she a handful. And yes, now we're controlling her. But yeah, like there's always situations like that in my life where if things hadn't lined up absolutely perfectly, I might not know people the way I do.
Having a really weird stroke.
We're stuck in this stupid thing.
Can you please let us out? Pretty please?
Oh, damn it, I was gonna goof around like an idiot again. Damn it, game!
My God, I thought we were goners. Another 10 minutes in there and I would have chewed off my own leg.
Oh.
Look, I got a lot of meat on my bones. So much.
Phrasing?
Yeah, right. Uh-huh.
Hey!
That is the rudeness.
Chris.
My goodness. Seems that someone has a little crush on our good friend and dear class president Michael Monroe.
Chris.
And what kind of sizzling erotica might our Jessica be capable of imagining? I wonder.
Let's see. Her, which one shall we go with? Left, right, ba, 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 ba. Ooh, making her seem a little crazy. Those eyeballs, the eyeball movements, they're a bit too much. Let's go with the popular option for once.
Mike and M split. We're together.
Whoa, drama.
Not really. Pretty clear cut, actually. M's out, I'm in.
Huh.
So yeah, we're gonna deal with one of those bits of drama here.
All right. Let's just get up to the lodge already. It's getting tired of all this nature and junk.
You guys go ahead. I'm just gonna wait here for a bit. See who else is coming.
Right.
What? I mean, you know, whoever.
Sure.
Sam.
Did you see this view? I mean, holy cow. Sometimes I forget to just stop and take it all in.
Yeah, it's kind of amazing. These developers did an amazing job. Anyways, here's Emily with her new boy toy.
I don't think it would have been like as pretty.
Matt, who is, and if I had to describe Matt in one word, it would be weenie. That's exactly what he is. He is a weenie.
And where's the bellboy?
As you are about to see quite quickly. Oh, and we're actually controlling him. Cool. Thought we controlled M during this part, but nope, we're controlling Mike.
Getting chilled.
We're almost there.
Or Matt, excuse me. Mike is the other guy.
Oh.
Emily has a thing for guys with whose first names start with the letter M, it seems.
Ah! Jesus!
Speaking of which, there he is. Mike, can you stop making such a creepy face? I wonder if the video is going to choose this as the thumbnail again. Just let's just have every thumbnail being all the creepy faces that Mike makes. Jesus Christ. Anyways, let's move on.
You guys.
Before I give you guys too much nightmare fuel.
Really should have seen your faces right there.
Dude, I almost clocked you just now.
Nice one.
Michael, you're a jerk.
Come on. Guys, we're all friends here, right? No need for violence, just a little harmless fun. We're up in the woods, it's spooky. Come on, let's get into the spirit of things.
The spirit of things? Seriously, what's wrong with you?
Oh, a lot of things, I'm certain.
Em, don't be like that.
Like what?
The way you're being. You always get like this.
Let's try to be cordial. Try to be a nice guy.
I'm just gonna lay it out, otherwise this whole weekend's gonna suck ass for everyone. This is super awkward, and we all know it. Let's just acknowledge it now and move on, okay?
Matt.
I hear you, man. I get it. I don't wanna make this weird.
Cool.
That'd be for the best.
We're good?
All good.
You guys gonna make out now?
Maybe.
Totally, we're so gonna make out. No, seriously, I'm gonna go check on the cable car back down the trip.
Alright, see you, man.
See ya.
Alright.
See ya!
Oh, crap.
Stupid Hydra agent.
Hey, could you take these the rest of the way?
The bags?
Yeah, all the bags.
Why?
I need to go find Sam.
Okay.
Sorry, I really need to go find her. I totally forgot I needed to talk to her before we get all the way up there.
This really can't wait. We're almost there.
It's important, Matt, please.
Let's see. Da 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 da. There's just so many choices per part. Like this basically is like half the gameplay, really. Let's go with persist.
Em, I really don't think you should head back down the trail by yourself.
Seriously?
It's cold out and it's getting dark.
You're gonna protect me from it being dark out?
I'll just leave your stuff here and come with you. Nobody's gonna steal it.
Matt, are you kidding me? You can't leave me alone for 5 minutes? You really think that little of me?
That's not what I meant.
Why can't you just listen to me? Why do you have to question everything I say?
I'm sorry, Em. I'm just trying to be helpful.
If you want to be helpful, then you can help get everything up to the lodge as quickly as you can, okay?
So yeah, great relationship these two have. Just absolutely perfect. No problems whatsoever. Absolute ideal couple right here. Couple goals, really. Alright, now we get to control Ashley, who has a crush on Chris, who, if you remember from like 2 minutes ago, said that Chris had a crush on Ashley. So these two have crush on each other, and neither of them is aware of it. So it's one of those gimmicks that we're going to have going on here. Let's just mosey around here using these binoculars.
Oh, hello. Somebody's getting a little friendly.
Yeah.
Friend zone kind of way. I might need to check the expiration date on their big breakup.
Oh!
Oh, God.
Hey, whoa. Sorry there.
Aren't you supposed to be going back up to the lodge?
Well, I did mean to scare you, sort of scare you, but not like for real scare you.
Oh my gosh, oh my gosh!
Hey, well, man, I'm really sorry, Ash, Dan.
It's okay, it's fine, it's fine.
What are you looking at? See anything juicy with that thing? Let me check it out.
Sure! Probably for the best, you know, so you know what you're getting yourself into. Just sipping my drink here, you know?
Seriously, Emily? What the hell, man?
Hey, listen, it's probably nothing.
Nothing, you think?
Well, yeah.
Is it ever just nothing with him?
Well, you know. I'm trying to form words, but you know. Things, stuff, words, sentences. Now we're back as Jessica once more. Read a book or check phone? Well, considering that she's basically just an older teenager, probably gonna check the phone. Gotta do that.
Oh, you did not just do that.
Put your hands where I can see them. We've got you surrounded.
But who am I to retaliate? What choice do I, a supple young rebel girl, have but to surrender to the strapping military guard come to take me into custody?
Quick time event time.
Well, I don't know when you put it like that. Hey!
It is Hamuski!
Great.
Yay, I nailed the QTE, at least this one. Can I do it once more?
Hiding, little
chick. And take that! Ooh, in the face!
Hey!
Oh, snap!
Missed me! Ooh, a burb. Pretty burb. Do not hit the burb. Don't hit the burb. Don't hit the burb.
Hey, Mike!
Boom, shakalaka!
Okay. You got me. Okay.
Do not hit the burb.
You can't hide from me, Michael. I know all your tricks.
Ha!
Ow.
You see, I did not hit the burb because I am a good person. Seriously, who hits birds? You gotta be a pretty low person to do that, in my opinion.
Gotcha! Done! Done city!
So did I go down?
I don't think so.
I think you'd know so if I did.
Alright.
My. So are we calling it my favor then?
You're a worthy opponent, Miss Jessica the Snowball.
Well, I did hit you all those times and you hit me zero!
My lady.
Let's go with... Boom! One more time! It's time to celebrate! One more time!
Well, I can think of at least one thing.
Yeah.
And I don't know why. It doesn't even matter how hard you try. Keep that in mind, the design that's trying to explain in due time. All I know, the time is a valuable thing. Watch it fly by as the pendulum swings.
I could stay out here for pretty much... ever, provided I was making out with you the whole time.
Just making out?
Quote, unquote.
Well, I think we might freeze to death somewhere in between those quotes.
Yeah.
Yay, another status update. Who could be on that car? Herm. Oh, another one of these with Mr. Peter Stormare.
Hello again. And how are we
feeling? I guess I could be better.
Seems we hardly scratched the surface in our last session, so let's go a little bit deeper this time.
Alrighty then, if you do care to do so.
This time.
If that is what you prefer.
We're going to try to understand the root of your anxiety.
Oh, my anxiety. That is just, that is a box of worms you do not want to enter.
Some symbols I want you to.
Or open, I guess I should say.
Image in each set makes you the most anxious.
Honestly, both worry me, so I don't know which one to choose. I guess manly man, and a swippity swipe. Let's see, planes don't really scare me as much as just when I'm on a plane, the turbulence really just gets to me. Like, it really makes me sick, so it's not so much scaring me, so I guess by default. Swipe that. Yeah, I definitely fear heights more than drowning. Mainly because I can swim. Snakes or rats? Snakes are rats. Gonna go with snickety snakes. Because at least I have pets around me that can protect me from rats. Alright, just doing your thing. Alright, you just doing there. I would have to say between guns and knives, guns are definitely scary because a knife, you know, just, you know, you can deflect a knife, you can just, there's a knife, just smack the knife rather and just use self-defense methods to, you know, get the knife out of the hand. There are several methods that you can use when it's a gun. It's like, they're like 20 feet away. They just, you can't do nothing about that. What's going to go with snakes? When it comes to roaches, I can at least stomp them. Alright, just gonna continue writing in your little book? Fine. Oh, that looks like one of the clowns from Killer Clowns from Outer Space. Swipe. Well, crows aren't really scary. I mean, who gets scared by crows, really? I mean, they're helpful. They're so helpful.
Oh. Did I startle you? So sorry. You're doing very well.
You dick.
Don't be nervous. Try to.
Ah, metronome.
The more you.
Okay then.
Stinks, the more honest your answer.
Tick tock, tick tock, tick tock, tickety tock. Oh, I'm going spiders. Didn't have to even think twice about that one. Oh, there's a lot of these. Oh, yeah, definitely this more than Neil. Neils don't scare me at all. I can handle that, no problem. Definitely clowns. Zombies kind of lost their scare factor this past decade, I gotta say. I think we need to go like 10 years without any zombie media before then to be scary again, at least. Not as much, because we've really been oversaturated between the two Walking Dead shows, all the zombie movies, all the zombie video games. Just, it's a bit much. It is a bit much. I'd say storms, especially if I'm outside during one. That was just, oh, I hate being outside during thunderstorms so much. That's just not my bag. Well, not so much during thunderstorms, but during lightning storms. Because there's something just about the flash of lightning that just really freaks me out. Just on an instinctual level, like on just a primal level, it just freaks me out.
The sun combination sounds like a good Friday night.
But the day most people are watching this is Saturday or Sunday, not Friday. Well, and now I have that Yakuza song stuck in my head again.
Out of time, but I promise we'll talk again very soon.
Well, I hope not. Creepy bastard. Yes, this game has these sort of segments on them, which is just really strange. I don't understand it because it's not like this game is divided into episodes. If it was divided into episodes like Alan Wake was, I would understand this formatting, but there's no opening, there's no credits. It's just randomly, after like a few hours of gameplay, it'll just be previously on Until Dawn. And then we get these sorts of things. It's really strange. I don't understand this design decision. It feels like something that was sort of thought up in an early stage of development, but just sort of just kept it because they liked how it looked, but then have anything else to go with it. And it's just a really strange decision. And I'm honestly surprised they kept it in. Like, it just makes no sense. Like, yeah, we know all this stuff happened. It happened in the last episode of this Let's Play. Jesus. And some of the stuff we just saw like 2 minutes ago.
Gosh, that's how we met.
Come on.
Butterfly effect. Man, I feel like this mountain gets bigger every time.
9 hours until dawn.
The same to me.
And here's Joshua. Probably the most famous actor from this, Mr. Rami Malek.
Probably feels like it's shrinking.
Known for his role in Mr. Robot. As well as Bohemian Rhapsody, and I'm sure by the time this comes out, there will be other stuff that I'm missing.
You got a spare million lying around.
I'm sure there's plenty of stuff on his IMDb page that he's really famous for that I do not know.
I think I left it in my other jacket.
Oops. Hey, guys. Get up here okay?
Yeah. Well, more or less, but it's so ridiculous.
One thing I will say is that everybody in this game puts in one hell of an acting job. Like, there's not really any bad acting per se in this entire game. Everyone plays their part perfectly. Sometimes that part can be annoying, but it is clearly done on purpose. Everyone's role is done 100% on purpose, clearly.
Yeah, man.
Let's be a helpful friend.
Hey, you doing all right? I mean, I know it must be really tough without your sister.
Stop.
I just meant that.
No, I know what you meant. You know, seriously, I'm over it. And I just want us to have a good time, you know? Like we always used to. Damn it. It's a freaking thing. It's iced. What else?
The door's iced shut. That sucks.
There's gotta be like a window around the corner we can get, like, get open or something.
Wait a second. Are you saying we should break in?
I don't think it's technically breaking in if you only...
That is a great point, Christopher.
If I don't report you.
Lead the way, coaches.
Hi, Chris.
Let's be a confident man.
So, how are you doing?
How you doing?
A little cold. I think I could use some time curled up by the fire.
Yeah, that does sound pretty nice.
All right, I guess we're just going to keep on walking then. And we're walking in the snowy winter. Then I hope I don't get here in Virginia because I hate it when it gets nice and snowy here because then the ice throats get icy and then get scared to drive on and it makes my anxiety get to 100% and I do not like that.
Hey, cut it out, man.
Yeah, I mean, if you're not gonna bang her, maybe Mike will take up the case.
Wait, will you back off already?
Relax. Just checking to see if there's some blood flowing down there.
Yeah.
Listen, dude, look around you. Look at these beautiful mountains. Do you see any parents? I mean, can you imagine a more perfect, ripe scenario just dripping with erotic possibilities?
Well, he did say partly porn stars in the previous part, so I guess that would... This sentence would be consistent with his line of thought. Let's go with the unpopular decision and see what happens.
I don't know, man.
How can you not know?
What if it's, like, weird? What if she might not, like, want to be friends with me anymore if I try something like that?
I mean, weren't you just listening? You gotta buck up, bro. Grow a pair.
And we're continuing our walking.
How are we planning on breaking into my parents' lodge, bud?
I didn't say I had a plan.
Almost at our destination.
Better deliver, Koshis, or else you got...
I do like how our walking leaves... Prince in the snow.
Check, that's not a good way to get late.
First, we have to push a box.
Nobody likes cool buns.
Well, we got ourselves a thinker. Nice one.
just got a just one more one more time. All right, here we go. And of course, we're going to be the ones to go in, because, you know, player character stops. Ouchies!
Oh, I'm okay. Should have paid more attention in climbing class.
You mean Jim?
Yeah, you know, with the climbing up the rope.
Whoa, that is suspicious.
I don't think so. Here, use this.
Is it dangerous to go alone?
Whoa, Chris, I just got an awesome idea.
Yeah?
Totally.
What is it?
Okay, so I'm pretty sure that I've got some deodorant in one of the bathrooms. You could use that with the lighter.
I don't follow. How's a stick of deodorant gonna help?
Spray on, it's a can.
Oh yeah, because you're a dickweed.
Yeah, now I gotcha.
I remember when I had those when I was in my teen years. I'm not too proud of that, to be honest, but, you know, we all go through that phase.
Bingo.
I hope. Please tell me that's not just me.
For hunting around in the dark for a little bit?
Nope, but I'll do it.
Godspeed, Pilgrim.
As you can see, that guy, he likes himself some film. Anyways, that is going to do it for this part of the Until Dawn Let's Play. Join me next time for more spoopiness. And yes, things will be getting just a little spooky. You know, for, you know, the first two parts here, things have just been kind of normalish. You know, just focusing on the drama. But the spookiness will ramp up in the next part. That much I promise. From what I remember, that is when it will happen. So please be sure to join me next time. If you enjoyed this video, please click the like and subscribe buttons. All that snazzy, jazzy stuff. Comment, sharing the video. All that stuff that other YouTubers say to do at the end of every video. I'm just rambling.